10 facts you may not know about Jesus in Islam. Most Christians imagine that Muslims dislike Jesus, or at best, are neutral towards him, or view him in the same way as Christians view Muhammad, peace be upon him. The truth is totally different. Here are 10 facts about the status Islam gives to Jesus, which you might have not heard before. 1. As told in the Quran, the story of Jesus starts with his grandmother, Imran's wife, who pledged her pregnancy to God's service. This pledge was accordingly fulfilled when she gave birth to Mary, Jesus' mother, who was the best woman of her age and one of the best of God's creations. The Quran says,
إذ قالت امرأة عمران رب إني نذرت لك ما في بطني محررا فتقبل مني إنك أنت السميع العليم فلما وضعتها قالت رب إني وضعتها أنثى والله أعلم بما وضعت وليس الذكر كالأنثى وإني سميتها مريم وإني أعيذها بك وذريتها من الشيطان الرجيم فتقبلها ربها بقبول حسن وأنبتها نباتا حسنا وكفلها زكريا كلما دخل عليها زكريا المحراب وجد عندها رزقا قال يا مريم أنى لك هذا قالت هو من عند الله إن الله يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب
2. Jesus' mother, Mary, is mentioned 31 times in the Quran, and she is the only woman mentioned by name in the Quran. Indeed, the Quran does not refer to any woman, including Muslim women, more times than Mary. She is not mentioned as many times in the New Testament either. What is more is that the surah, or chapter 19 in the Quran, is named after her. And you can easily read this surah on the internet. It's only 7 pages. 3. Muslims believe that Jesus is not merely a prophet, but also one of the top 5 of God's messengers to mankind. These 5 are given the description of being the messengers of firm resolve. A Muslim is not a true believer unless he believes that Jesus, peace be upon him, was God's servant, messenger, and word, which he gave to Mary and a soul from him. 4. Muslims believe in the virgin birth of Jesus. He had no father, and his birth was a miracle to show God's power and the special status of Jesus. It was also a test and an honor to his mother, who endured people's criticism. The Quran quotes her words. She said,
قالت أنى يكون لي غلام ولم يمسسني بشر ولم أك بغيا
5. Jesus spoke in infancy, and this was his first miracle, and evidence of his prophethood. The Quran records what he said in infancy to defend his mother.
فأشارت إليه قالوا كيف نكلم من كان في المهد صبيا قال إني عبد الله آتاني الكتاب وجعلني نبيا وجعلني مباركا أينما كنت وأوصاني بالصلاة وجعلني مباركا أينما كنت أوصاني بالصلاة والزكاة ما دمت حيا وبرًا بوالدتي ولم يجعلني جبارًا شقيا والسلام علي يوم ولدت ويوم أموت ويوم أبعث حيا.
6. According to Islam, Jesus' mission is very clear: to call people to worship God alone, associating no partners with Him.
ما قلت لهم إلا ما أمرتني به أن اعبدوا الله ربي وربكم وكنت عليهم شهيدا ما دمت فيهم فلما توفيتني كنت أنت الرقيب عليهم وأنت على كل شيء شهيد.
He also announced the forthcoming of God's last messenger.
وَإِذْ قَالَ عِيسَى ابْنُ مَرْيَمَ يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيَّ مِنَ التَّوْرَاةِ وَمُبَشِّرًا بِرَسُولٍ يَأْتِي مِنْ بَعْدِ اسْمُهُ أَحْمَدُ فلما جاءهم بالبينات قالوا هذا سحر مبين.
7. Muslims believe in the different miracles Jesus was given. He brought the dead back to life. Yes, you heard that right. And he fashioned from clay the figure of a bird and breathed into it. And it became a living bird. Yes, you heard this right, too. And he cured people who were sick with different illnesses. He did all this by God's will. 8. When Muslims mention Jesus, they say, peace be upon him, in the same way as they do after mentioning the name of Prophet Muhammad, or Prophet Abraham, or any other prophet. They do so to pay their respect to God's prophets. 9. According to Islam, Jesus, peace be upon him, was not crucified. God raised him to himself. This is the truth God has told us in the Quran.
وقولهم إنا قتلنا المسيح عيسى بن مريم رسول الله وما قتلوه وما صلبوه ولكن شبه لهم وإن الذين اختلفوا فيه لفي شك منه ما لهم به من علم إلا اتباع الظن وما قتلوه يقينا بل رفعه الله إليه وكان الله عزيزا حكيما.
10. The last fact may come as a surprise. Muslims believe that Jesus will return at the end of time, and he will kill the impostor. He will spread justice and goodness among people. Everyone will have plenty, so that people would look at money and not take it. He will break the crucifix, declaring the fallacy of the claim that the Jews crucified him. He will kill the pig in order to purge his message of distortion. These 10 facts may come as a surprise, but you can easily find what the Quran and Prophet Muhammad say about Jesus, which is what Muslims believe. I promise that you will find even more surprising facts.